Hi everyone, this is Matilda. I'm working as a research assistant in Pentagrid. This session is going to be a more interesting section. The topic for this session is behavioral changes in different stages of Alzheimer's disease in zebrafish model. Alzheimer's is the chronic neurodegenerative disease. It is an irreversible progressive brain disorder in which the death of brain cells slowly destroys memory, thinking skills, cognitive decline, and eventually the ability to carry out the simplest tasks. Alzheimer's is the most common cause of dementia among older adults. Dementia is a broad category of brain diseases. As the disease advances, symptoms include memory loss, movement disorder, problems with the language, and disorientation. Alzheimer's disease is caused by genetic defects or environmental triggers or due to aging. It attacks nerves and brain cells as well as neurotransmitters. The destruction of these parts causes clumps of proteins such as plaques and bundles to form around the brain cells and start to destroy more connections between the brain cells, which makes the condition worse. Plaques develop in the hippocampus and in other areas of the cerebral cortex. Alzheimer's disease is characterized by amyloid beta containing plaques and intracellular neurofibrillary tangles consisting of abnormal phosphorylated tau protein in the brain. Zebrafish possess two homologs of amyloid precursor protein with good homology to human amyloid precursor protein. Studies have demonstrated the presence of the functional gamma secretase machinery to produce amyloid beta in zebrafish. There are nearly 7 stages of observed cognitive impairment in humans, which can be well addressed in zebrafish Alzheimer's disease model. In stage 1, the fishes do not exhibit any cognitive changes or physiological changes. With the progression of the disease symptoms like slow movement, emaciation, and shoaling behavior are observed, which can be correlated with stage 2 in humans. When the neuronal cells start to degenerate, the movement of the fish starts to decrease prominently in the third stage. Abnormal body posture, drooping tail, and mild bending in the body, corkscrew swimming is observed in the further stages of the disease. In the fifth stage, the fishes exhibit corkscrew swimming or burst coast movement as well as uncoordinated movements as observed in humans with Alzheimer's. In the sixth stage, the fishes have hitting behavior or surface touching behavior and sudden dispersion to the bottom of the tank. In the last stage, with the advancement in the disease, the model decreases the feed intake and also exhibit weak and wobbling movement leading to death. Different experimental setup are used to monitor the prognosis of Alzheimer's disease. In stage 2, the symptoms are predicted by following assays like motor coordination, swim velocity, and shoaling effect. To study the motor coordination, the experimental fish tank was divided into quadrants with solid lines, and the model were allowed to acclimatize for a period of 60 seconds. Video analyses were used to determine the behavior of the model with respect to specific endpoints such as number of quadrants changed, swim velocity, and time spent in each quadrant. On screen are the graphs representing the motor coordination and social interaction. The average quadrant change is observed to decrease in model corresponding to the swim velocity in comparison to control. Next is shoaling effect. Video analysis shows difference between control and model, where the model is observed to show polarized tight shoal in contrast to control with non-polarized free shoal. In stage 3, the model was screened for the prognosis of the disease with respect to motor coordination, swim velocity, and memory. With the decreased progression, the model is observed to have much more compromised motor coordination in comparison to stage 2. A maze tank was used to understand the learning and memory potential in the model. It is not only used to understand the memory, but also to assess the model capability to learn and recognize the feed and learning potential to identify their brain signals. The experimental maze tank consists of 3 hurdles in between the start and the end. The zebrafish is introduced to one end of the tank and the feed is introduced to the other end. The time taken by the fish to recognize the feed after crossing all the hurdles is observed for feed recognition capacity. Once reaching the feed, the observation is continued to quantify the learning potency by recording the time taken by the fish to get back to the start point. The observations show that the model takes 5-fold increased time to reach back to the start point, indicating poor memory and learning potential. In stage 3, the model was screened for the progression of the disease with respect to motor coordination,
maximum velocity and memory. With the disease progression, the model is observed to have much more compromised motor coordination in comparison to stage 2. A maze tank was used to understand the learning and memory dysfunction in the model. It is not only used to understand the memory, but also to assess the model capability to learn and recognize the fear and learning potential to identify their brain signals. The experimental maze tank consists of 3 hurdles between the start and the end point. The zebrafish is introduced to one end of the tank and the feed is introduced to the other end. The time taken by the fish to recognize the feed after crossing all the hurdles is observed for feed recognition capacity. Once reaching the feed, observation is continued to quantify the learning potential of by recording the time taken by the fish to get back to the start point. The observations show that the model takes 5-fold increased time to reach back to the start point, indicating poor memory and learning potential. In stage 3, the model was screened for the progression of the disease with respect to motor coordination, swim velocity, and memory. With the disease progression, the model is observed to have much more compromised motor coordination in comparison to stage 2. A maze tank was used to understand the learning and memory dysfunction in the model. It is not only used to understand the memory, but also to assess the model capability to learn and recognize the feed and learning potential to identify their brain signals. The experimental maze tank consists of 3 hurdles between start and the end point. The zebrafish is introduced to one end of the tank and the feed is introduced to the other end. The time taken by the fish to recognize the feed after crossing all the hurdles is observed for feed recognition capacity. Once reaching the feed, the observation is continued to quantify their learning potency by recording the time taken by the fish to get back to the start point. The observations show that the model takes 5-fold increased time to reach back to the start point, indicating poor memory and learning potency. The stage 4 symptoms are analyzed by using the novel object recognition test, corkscrew swimming, and motor coordination. In the novel object recognition test, the zebrafish is introduced into the tank and the tank is fixed with the novel object on one side and the familiar object on the other. Observe the time spent by the fish with the novel object and the familiar one. On the screen is the graph between the control and model. In control, the time spent with the novel object is maximum than the familiar object. Where in model, the time spent with familiar object is maximum than the novel object. The fish is introduced into the experimental tank from the housing tank and count the number of corkscrew swimming occurs in the tank for a minute. The graph represents the presence of corkscrew movement in model, indicating compromised motor coordination. Again, the motor coordination assay is carried out in stage 4. In this stage, the swim motion is decreased by half bit compared with stage 2. In stage 5, the startle response and motor coordination assays are performed to assess the progression of the disease. In startle response, the setup consists of inner static circular tank filled with water and an outer static circular tank with frightening object. Allow the fish into the water and rotate the outer circular tank in a clockwise direction and in anti-clockwise direction for 20 times. As soon as the fish reach the threatening object, the fish exhibit the sudden response and move away from the threat. In the screen, there is a graph between number of threats and number of response for control and model are plotted. The occurrence of C bend in response over the frightening object occurs only in model and not in control. Once again, the motor coordination test is carried out to notice the step-by-step decrease of movement in the Alzheimer's model. There is no much difference in swim motion in stage 5 and stage 4. Next is visual appearance, diatact test, number of hits and number of surface touch at the given time are performed in stage 6. In this video, visual appearance exhibits the abnormal body posture or mind bend in the body. The adult zebrafish is allowed in the study tank and count the number of hits occurs in a given time of 3 minutes. In this plot, the hitting behavior is observed only in model fish. In novel diet tank, the tank is filled with water and separated into 2 sections, that is top section and bottom section. The fish is introduced into the study tank from the housing tank and calculate the time spent by the fish in the bottom and top layer of the tank. The Alzheimer's model suddenly moves to the bottom of the tank and spends time, is observed to spend more time at the bottom, whereas the control was observed to exhibit more of an exploratory behavior throughout the tank. Following the novel diet tank test, the surface touching assay is carried out. It is dwelling of fish at the surface of the water. The fish is allowed in the experimental tank and count the number of surface touch occurs in a given time. In the screen, there is a graph with more number of surface touch occurs in model due to Beyoncé dysregulation. Cytology smears was performed by euthanizing the fish at 4 degrees Celsius. Brain was dissected and fixed on glass slides. Hematoxylin and eosin stains were used for differential staining. On the screen is the pathology smear of the brain control A and model B, representing the neuronal brain cells. Control shows normal neuronal cells, whereas more number of aggregates of degenerative cells are observed in model, indicating severe neurodegeneration. In summary, the endpoints occur in humans in each stages are used as a model in zebrafish for screen. Thank you. This is Matilda signing from you and see you back again with next interesting topic.